Nearly two decades after the Concorde was retired, supersonic passenger flights around the world could once again be within reach. Calling it the world's fastest and longest-range purpose-built business jet, plane manufacturer Bombardier's Global 8000 boasts speeds of over 750 miles per hour. And joining me now on this is CNN aviation correspondent Pete Muntean. Pete, the company is calling this the world's fastest jet. So does that mean that, you know, breakfast in New York and then lunch in Sydney, can I do this?
It's all about bragging rights, Brianna. You know, we're talking about the fastest civilian airplane that money can buy, the Bombardier Global 8000. 8,000 comes from the range, 8,000 nautical miles. The top speed, Mach 0.94. So we're talking about 94% of the speed of sound. There has not been a civilian airplane built faster than this since the Concorde. It can carry up to 19 passengers. Remember, this is a business jet, a private plane, not really a passenger plane that you and I would fly on. More on this in a second. So let's just get a little perspective on how fast we're talking about here. Mach 1, the speed of sound, 761 miles per hour at sea level. It varies with temperature, a few other factors. So most private planes, the fastest you could get is about Mach 0.92. Up until now, we're talking about Mach 0.94. Long time ago, we were talking about the Concorde, retired in 2003. It was up here past Mach 2. So still a long way to go for what we saw back in the Concorde. But remember, retired back in 2003, it was plagued by tons of problems. It was really expensive to repair. The airlines didn't want to fly it anymore. It was tiny, but it could get about 100 people from New York to Paris in about 3 hours, which is a pretty incredible speed. The test flight, the test bed for the Bombardier Global 8000, went Mach 1.015 in a bit of a descent. So that means that it was going a little bit faster downhill, but it was chasing a F-18, so going pretty darn fast, Brianna. All of this speed means more range on the same amount of fuel. We're talking, Houston to Dubai, London to Perth, Singapore to LA, if you ever need to go that far. It's not built for the every person. This is more of something where you need to go, let's say to Dubai for breakfast, for a meeting. These orders are up in the pandemic. Private planes have actually been doing pretty well compared to commercial airliners, which have been down a little bit. So it's a pretty interesting time for business and private planes like this. We haven't seen something like this in a long, long time.
Okay, so let's talk about the cost. And does this include one of those like nice warm face towelettes and a champagne? I mean, what does this come with? What are you gonna pay for it?
It is pretty bougie, maybe for you and I. a little salty, maybe not for Berman, but maybe for you and I, it might be a little difficult. Okay, so let's talk about the interior here. Four different zones of the cabin. Pretty plush. Might see a mahogany table like this. You can see the pretty advanced cockpit there. Up to 19 people on board, depending on the configuration. We're not gonna see this at the airlines. We may see it at the airlines from a company called Boom Supersonic. And some of these planes, 15 orders were just put in by United Airlines, might not see a supersonic plane at the airlines until something like 2029. But this is something that would do Newark to London in about 3.5 hours. Speed is king here. The airlines are dying for it, and so are people with a lot of money. $78 million for the Bombardier Global 8000, Brianna.
That is a fancy plane on the inside, Berman. Did you see that? It definitely comes with a moist face towelette.
I did see it right after Pete Muntean called me bougie. So, yes, that caught my attention.
Just making sure you're on your toes, John.
I'm the guy who falls asleep and, like, drools a little bit.
He mows his own lawn, Pete. He's not bougie.
Well, you know. I think he could afford it. We'll see. Take out a loan.
London to Perth. I'm headed there. Definitely. That's one of my regular routes.
Yeah. Right? Definitely. Just for lunch. Yeah. Pete, thanks for showing us that. What a treat.